It really is a drug poisoning crisis. Supply that we used to know, it's so contaminated, so potent, and so deadly. And that's one of the big reasons that we're seeing such an increase in drug poisoning deaths. It's very challenging. It's heartbreaking for those working on the front line, and it's heartbreaking for the families that are affected by drug poisoning deaths. And it's 100% preventable.
Edmonton's a big place. So if you have limited resources and a big piece of territory, where do you focus your efforts?
Is there some way that we can use data to help? Everything came together kind of in a 2-week period. We kind of dropped everything. We're like, how can we get this moving quickly? So we started work on a dashboard just by looking for data.
So far, we've pulled in data from Edmonton Fire Rescue Service and Edmonton Transit and Reach Edmonton. Everybody's contributing in different ways and working together. Once we looked at this data, it was a bit shocking to see. Usually you look at the data and it's just numbers that go up and down, whatever, but these are people's lives and potentially lives lost, but definitely lives affected in a negative way, and it makes it much more emotional looking at the data. So a project like this, the data privacy is paramount.
There is no personally identifying information for individuals. The only thing that we're interested in is time, type, and location. We basically work with a grid of squares overlaying the city that are 250 meters by 250 meters. And then we basically just say how many incidents are in each of those squares. So we have this really intuitive map of where the hotspots are, allowing people to know where they're supposed to go and where the priority areas are.
Data and evidence-based process is really, really important to me. We can use that dashboard to determine where our team needs to rapidly deploy to. So we do a lot of crisis outreach in known areas of concern. And we also do a lot of education and advocacy. We hand out and have handed out hundreds of naloxone kits to community members, people who use drugs, and their friends. We can train them right there on the spot. So we're making it a very low barrier access to naloxone, which is the drug used to reverse an opioid poisoning.
We can never replicate services that are being provided by these outreach workers. That's really what's saving lives. That's really the meaningful work. Now, this isn't going to solve the issue. We have no illusions of this solving the issue, but we do know that this is going to help prioritize some of our efforts.
This isn't just a drug poisoning crisis in our city. It's directly interlinked with affordable housing, with food insecurity, with trauma. While we talk about drug poisoning, we also have to look at all the other social determinants of health that make us as a city healthy and safer for everyone.